Hi, in this new grasshopper tutorial we will learn how to create a faceted loft. Here I can control the number of faces. Also at the end we will learn how to subdivide each face into two triangles. We will use a free plugin for grasshopper. It's called Lunchbox. You can download it from Food for Rhino. I will put a link for it in the description. So now let's start from scratch. Okay, here we have two curves. I will reference these curves inside Grasshopper. I will use the curve component, right click, set one curve. I will choose this one. Then another component, set one curve. I can hide the original curves. The first thing we should do here is to rebuild those two curves. So type rebuild curve. I will plug the curve, and here it's asking me for the number of control points, the control points that controls the creation of the curve. So I will choose a number between 3 and 50. I will hide the this curve here so we can see. Here the degree, in our case, to be able to create a faceted loft, we need to change the degree to 1. As you can see, when the degree is 1, the interpolation between each control point is a straight line. Here I have 3 control points. Okay. So now I will use, I will copy paste these here, and I will plug this curve and I will hide it. Okay. I will delete this one here, and I can also delete this one. I will use these sliders for both. So now I can use the loft tool from the surface loft. I will plug the first curve, and I will press shift to add to the input. So now I have these I will have this faceted loft. I can increase the number of faces. Now, if I want to subdivide each polygon, each face, to two triangles, I will use the Lunchbox plugin. Go to Panels, Triangular Panels A. It's asking me for the face, for the surface. Now, here the output of Loft is Open B-Wrap. So what I should do, I can go to Surface, Deconstruct B-Wrap, here we have 11 faces, because we have 12 control points, the result is 11 faces. So I will plug the faces output to the surface. I will hide this one. By default we have U and V divisions with 10 by 10. We only need one for this case here. So now each polygon is subdivided to two triangles. I can right click and bake the result. Now each, you can select each triangle separately. I will unhide the original curves. And basically that's it for this video. I hope you learned something, and if you like it, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel, and see you on the next video. Thank you.